Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. Today we'll be looking at top 10 beginner tips in Marvel Future Revolution. The very first thing is choosing your right server, because the first thing we'll be doing is choose when after installing a Marvel Future Revolution. First thing, right, it will be we'll be landing on this page, so we need to choose the right server. By default they will be choosing a best server for us. If you want to play with your friends, you need to make sure you choose the right server. If you want to change the server, click on the server name. For me it's showing like Omega Flight, and then click on change region and choose the region where you want to create a server. So for example, if I want to go to Southeast Asia, so I choose Southeast Asia, then click on change region, then you can choose the server. So make sure, like your first time when you are logging in, choose the you are choosing the correct server. So otherwise, suppose if you want to play with your friends, you may not be able to play with them. Tip number two, choosing your first character. So they will be by default provided with option to create four different characters. So the easy characters are beginner friendly characters will be like Doctor Strange, Iron Man, Storm or Spider-Man. So these all four characters we can easily play. They are like easy to play, friendly or beginner friendly characters. Captain America and Black Widow, they will be tough when you are choosing them as a first characters. But if you want to play, you can play them. You can play like different characters. So make sure you are choosing your first character correctly, so that you can continue playing. Tip number three. So make sure whichever the character you want to level up to the maximum, you make sure you are logging with them every time, every day, so that all the rewards will be go to this particular character only. Otherwise, if you log in with some other character, the reward will be going to the other character. So this is what I was telling about. So you can see that I logged in with the Doctor Strange, so I get this reward for my character. It may be a costume or something. Costumes or we cannot transfer, and make sure we are choosing the right character when you are logging in for first time for the day. We can craft regional gears by buying mats in Alliance store, and some raids also we can do. So let me show you how you are crafting the gears. Suppose if you want to craft a regional set, we can come to this workshop and choose which region costume you want to created. This is random. It's not guaranteed to provide a particular region costume. If you are lucky, we may get this. So in order to craft a region costume, we need this mats to craft it. For example, I want to create a Hydra Empire costumes, so I need this mat. You can see like where we can get this mats. So we can either acquire them through farming through in Hydra Empire, or in, let me show you in another place where we can get this. You can go to Alliance store. Now I click on Alliance. You can go to Alliance shop. So here you can see that our regional costume material, this is like a weekly refresh. We can buy as much as possible. I'm not sure what is the maximum limit. So we'll get like 20 mats for this crafting gears. So it will come to a certain box. So I'm crafting a Hydra region costume, so I can choose this, and this match will be going to my inbox again. Choose the right regional costumes so that you can craft the gear. So once you get this, come to workshop again. So I want to craft a Hydra Empire costume. So now I have the mats for this fabric. Next one is a sin particle. So how we can acquire them is through special operations. So this is like a daily task. Make sure you do it, and now we'll get like a sin particle box. We'll get some materials from this. Make sure you do this task on a daily basis to get the sin particles. So once you have all these mats, then you can click on craft. So we'll be crafting also. It go to this progress bus. I unlocked additional three crafting slot. By default they will be giving one. We can buy additional crafting slots through crystals, in-game crystals. These crystals I got from this free crystals only. So I have played like different characters, so we can get like a lot of crystals as a free. So once I craft it, I can claim this. So even though I'm crafting a Hydra costume, it's not guaranteed me to provide this Hydra costume every time. It's a random. If you are lucky, only we'll get this. Otherwise, we might be getting something junk like this. But we can make use of this to combine them to a higher level gear. So don't delete it. So I'm crafting the next one. Oh no. Okay. Oh, this is like you can complete this by clicking this gold, but don't spend gold. Let it craft. Let the crafting complete automatically. It takes 2 hours to complete this crafting. Tip number 6: card storage. So card storage is like if you want to your cards to be transferred to some other character, what we can do is go to your squad section and click on card storage. So from this card inventory, this card storage which we are seeing on the right side is like a global to our all our other characters. So we can easily transfer, we can make use of this cards to the other characters, so they will be powerful. So I can store these characters in the storage and I can retrieve the same thing in some other character. So this is a helpful one. So next one is a inventory storage. So card storage we are only using for to store the cards, but inventory storage we can store various, even if you want to store some health packs or some other materials, or even can transfer battle badges. Suppose if you want to transfer the battle badges, it will come to this storage. Here you can see that I can, let me store some very old health packs. So I can store this health consumables or battle badges or some other cores or even costumes. There is no point in transferring costumes. So we can, this is like a common inventory for all other characters. We can retrieve from here as well. Tip number 7: we can dismantle badges. Suppose sometimes our inventory will be overflown, at the time we can delete this 1-star, even 2-star, 3-stars, all this we can dismantle, because they will be useless for us in the long run. If it is a new character, they might be help you, but if your character level is high, this won't be help you much. So you can dismantle them easily and it will give you some gold and some convergent particles as well. Tip number 8: we can switch zones. If you want to go to a different zone from this your headquarters or from anywhere else, we can simply click the map on the top left side and click on the world map on the bottom right. So through this world map we can go to any zone from this place. If I want to go to Hydra Empire, I can click this Hydra Empire, and inside that there will be two different maps are there. If I want to click Hell's Kitchen, click, and if I click go, it will take me to that map. Tip number 9: if you want to earn gold, obviously we can do this various operation task, blitz or most wanted. All this gives you some decent goals, and currently some event is going on. This is like a one time only. So apart from earning gold, we'll be getting squad XP and some other consumable box also, like battle badges we'll be getting along with this. So we can do like blitz, special operations, they will give like 50,000 gold, and battle challenge, they here will be completing various challenges. In this, not only gold, you will be getting various things like gear, crystals, some draw tickets. So these are like various ways we can earn gold. Raid is also like one thing, we will get some decent gold. So make sure you do this on a daily basis to earn some gold. Apart from this, we can, by completing daily challenges, we'll be earning gold as well nicely. You can see that there are like a different almost like 50,000 or 60,000 golds we can get from this daily. So we will be, if we complete like various challenges, so we'll be getting golds for them as well. Tip number 10: if you want to buy a new character slot, go to that store section By default, you'll be given like four hero slots. If you want like additional hero slots, come to consumables. Here you can see that hero slot expansion ticket. If you buy this, it will go to your inventory, and from there you need to click use. So it will go to your inventory. From there, click on this consumable section. If you click on use, it will unlock as a new hero slot. So it will provide an additional slot like this, so you can create a new character after buying this. Bonus step, so you can make use of this autoplay section, autoplay option in this game. So it will be just above this camera section. If you click this autoplay, and if you click on any quest, it will take us to there and complete this task. For example, let me take a quest from here. So if I want to complete this green quest, side quest is, so all I need to do is click on auto, enable this autoplay and choose the quest. So it will automatically complete the task for us. We need to go there and do it, and it also automatically comes back to that quest giver and it will complete the task. And if there is any further section also, it automatically take us to the next section. Once it is completed, we need to click complete. So this is one usage of autoplay, or else if you are attacking an enemy, it will be helpful at the time as well. So it automatically uses the special powers we have, except the ultimate skill, it makes use of all the special powers. So apart from this, how can you use this autoplay? So if you want to go to any place on the map, so choose the map, and if you click on a location, it automatically takes us there. We no need to run manually. So here you can see that Iron Man is automatically going there. So this is one advantage of using autoplay. Thank you for watching my video. If you like my video, subscribe to my channel. Thank you.